Father also refers to a begetter or an originator, and one in intimate connection and relationship. Amen. Because remember that we're talking about putting your focus on what's primary to God's heart. We're talking about intimacy with the Father. We're talking about knowing Him on another level, in another dimension, in another realm. We're talking about being one with God. Hallelujah. So to know the Father, hallelujah, as a nourisher, as a protector, and an upholder, this means that you're totally relying on Him to provide your nourishment, your sustenance. Amen. That instead of looking to man, you're looking to God as your protector. Hallelujah. And His angels are encamped around you. Amen. And so when we look at God the Father as a progenitor of a people, and we look at Abraham as being the forefather, so Abraham, that was he was called. Amen. And so let's go a line upon line and precept upon precept as we look at some of the word of God here. Hallelujah. And I put some of the scriptures up and some I wasn't able to get on the screen, but we're going to see what the Lord is going to say. The Lord says here in Psalm 51, and I'm going to read through a few verses there. Gather together to me, my saints, those who have found grace in my sight, those who have made a covenant with me by sacrifice. And the heavens declare His righteousness, rightness and justice from God. For God, He is the judge. Hallelujah. For the world and its fullness are mine. So offer to God the sacrifice of thanksgiving and pay your vows to Most High. So, no, stay there, sir. The Lord is showing us here that those who have made a covenant with me by sacrifice. So not only is the covenant a binding agreement, but when you walk in covenant relationships are those that are making sacrifices. Even when we have covenant relationships with one another, if you have covenant relationship with your spouse, with your children, with your friends and your partners, when you have a covenant relationship, you know that it's covenant when the people are making sacrifices, when the relationship is reciprocal and it's not just a one-way, it's a two-way street, it's a win-win situation, amen? Because it's a difference between lust and love. Remember, lust takes and love gives. So we know the difference when we have people in our lives that are just taking from us and never giving anything back. So we need to be understanding what a covenant is. Amen? And so you can go to the next one now. Amen. And call on me in the day of trouble. I will deliver you and you shall honor and glorify me. Hallelujah. He who brings an offering of praise and thanksgiving honors and glorifies me. And he who orders his way aright, who prepares the way that I may show him, to him I will demonstrate my salvation. So God gives some directives here. He's letting us know that if you want to receive honor and glory from God, you have to walk in this attitude and disposition of oneness with God, of seeing Him as your covenant God. Hallelujah. A God who has already done all the sacrificing He's going to do. He laid down His life for us. He gave us His very best. Hallelujah. God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son. See, God is not a luster. He's a lover. Hallelujah. He's a lover of our soul. Hallelujah. When we begin to walk in His image and likeness, we're going to begin to love on one another. We're going to be able to give out of a pure heart, an unfeigned heart. You understand what I mean? Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. So God is asking us to bring an offering of praise and thanksgiving that honors and glorifies Him. Hallelujah. And He will order His way aright. That means God is going to order your steps. Hallelujah. As you honor the word of God, you submit to the authority of God's word. When you're looking at the word, you're actually looking at God. You're saying, God, you know what's best. You know what's right for me. Your ways are not my ways. Your thoughts are not my thoughts. Hallelujah. I'm aligning my thoughts with your thoughts and my mind with your mind and my heart with your heart and my will with your will. I'm constantly dying to self. I'm dying to my will. I'm dying to leaning on my own understanding, and I'm acknowledging you in all my ways, and you're directing my path, because the Lord is going to give you something in your spirit to let you know that you're on the right way, that you're going the right way. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If someone could get for me John 8, verse 38, if you'd be so kind. Hallelujah. You can help me preach on today. Glory to God. Glory to God. God, yes. John 8, 38, and then 41 and 44. Yes. Can you read loudly, please?
Okay. John 8,
38.
38, I read. I speak what I have seen with my Father, and you do what you have seen with your Father. They answered and said to him, Abraham is our father.
Yes.
Jesus said to them, if you were Abraham's children, you would do the works of Abraham.
Go down to 44, keep going.
But now you seek to kill me, a man who has told you the truth, which I hear from God. Abraham did not do this.
Mm-hmm.
You do the deeds of your father. Then they said to him, we are not born of fornication. We have one father, God. Jesus said to them, if God were your father, you will love me. For I proceeded forth and came from God. Not have I come to myself, but he sent me. Why do you not understand my speech? Because you are not able to listen to my word.
Mm-hmm.
You are of your father, the devil. And the desire of your father, you want to do. He was a murderer from the beginning. And does not stand in the truth. Because there is no truth in him. When he speaks a lie, he speaks from his own resources. For he is a liar and a father of lies.
Amen. Thank you, woman of God. Hallelujah. So you hear what the Lord is saying here. We have opportunities every day, hallelujah, to speak life or death, right? Amen.
Amen.
And because we're born in the image and likeness of God, and just like Jesus was, he came and he was baptized in grace and truth. And we're supposed to walk in grace and truth. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So we're children of Abraham. Hallelujah. We're walking in truth in this hour. Hallelujah. According to 1 Corinthians 4 and 15, one who stands in a father's place and looks after another in a paternal way, by virtue of wisdom and experience in which they excel to take charge of the interests of others. Hallelujah. So basically it's here showing that we are a covenant people, and we are a covenant family, and we're bearing the image of the Holy Trinity. That's the goal. See, we share in the fellowship of his suffering to be made conformable to his death, that we can know him in the power of his resurrection. Hallelujah. So when you refer in your time of devotion, you go to James 1 and 17. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Let me see if I can find that real quick. Thank you, Lord. Yes, it says, every good gift and every perfect, free, large, full gift is from above. It comes down from the Father of all that gives light in, hallelujah, the shining. I'm sorry. Yes, in the shining of whom there can be no variation, rising or setting or shadow cast by turning as in an eclipse. And it was of his own free will that he gave us birth as sons. Hallelujah. By his word of truth, so that we should be a kind of first fruits of his creation. Hallelujah. Understand this, my beloved brethren. Let every man be quick to hear, a ready listener, slow to speak, slow to take offense, and to get angry. For a man's anger does not promote the righteousness of God. Hallelujah. And so God here is exhorting us to be doers of the word and not just hearers only. Not deceiving ourselves. Amen. God says here, for if any be a hearer of the word and not a doer, he is like a man beholding his natural face in a glass, for he beholded himself and goeth his way and straightway forgetting what kind of person he was. Hallelujah. So we don't want to forget who we are. Amen. Hallelujah. We want to look into the mirror of God's word and reflect the glory of God. Hallelujah. The Lord is showing us here that he's an upholder. He's a ruler. He's a father of lights. He's a preserver. He's a guardian. He's a protector. Hallelujah. We revere him, hallelujah, as our reconciled, loving father. Hallelujah. He reconciled us back to him through Christ Jesus. Amen. And he's ordained us as ministers of reconciliation to reconcile individuals back to God through Christ Jesus, back to themselves, back to their families, and then back to their communities. Hallelujah. So we have an assignment. Amen. Hallelujah. When we're one with God, one by the power of his spirit, and operative in the gospel has begotten them a new life to holiness. So when you know that you're walking in the oneness of God, you're walking in the power of his spirit. That means he's giving you the anointing, hallelujah, to walk in this new life of holiness. Hallelujah. One whom God has united to himself. When he's reconciled you to him, he's united you to himself in a close bond of love and intimacy. Hallelujah. This is meaning that he's made you acquaintance with his purpose. Hallelujah. And is appointed to explain and carry out among men and women the plan of salvation and made to share in his divine nature. Hallelujah. So when we walk in this oneness with God, we feel a bond with God. We feel close to his heart. We're not just honoring God with our lips and our heart is far away from him, but we're examining ourselves on a daily basis and asking God, hallelujah, are you pleased with what I'm doing in my life? Amen. You're asking God, you know, to understand his purpose and plan for your life. You want to know his redemptive purpose and plan. You want to know his plan for healing the souls, hallelujah, that are assigned to you. Amen. Hallelujah. Because we're sharing in his divine nature. That means we're just going to be showing some characteristics that we're going to be talking about in a few minutes. Hallelujah. You can go to the next slide. Hallelujah. In Isaiah 8, 13, 14, and 18, it says, the Lord of hosts regard him as holy and honor his holy name by regarding him as your only hope and your only safety. And let him be your fear and let him be your dread, lest you offend him by your fear of man and distrust of him. So sometimes we get offended, but did you know that your father gets offended?
Yeah.
Did you know that your father gets offended when we trust in man that we can see more than we trust in him? Amen. The word of God talks about you're going to feel the effects of the curse if you trust in man. Amen. Wow. But it says, blessed is the man who trusted in the Lord. Amen. See, we've been redeemed from the curse of the law through the sacrifice of Jesus. He came to destroy the works of the devil. So as you are walking in the righteousness of God, knowing that he's already defeated the works of the devil. Hallelujah. And we're not cursed. God broke that curse through the blood sacrifice. Hallelujah. But if you don't know who you are, you're going to live like you're still under the curse. The earth is cursed, but you're blessed. Amen. He cursed the earth. Amen. But when Jesus brought back our redemption, he brought back what Adam forfeited, amen, we begin to walk in the spiritual authority that God has given us, and we begin to exemplify the divine nature of God. And it says, and he shall be a sanctuary. That means he's going to be a sacred and indestructible asylum to those who reverently fear and trust him. This is a reverence that we have for God. This is a reverential fear that we have of God. Not afraid of him punishing us, but we're reverencing him and honoring him as our creator, as the one that sustains us, as the one who maintains us, as the one that supplies all our needs according to his riches and glory, the one that has good thoughts to us and not evil, that he has a hope and a future for us. We're resting in knowing that he made us very good, that he made us fearfully and wonderfully made, that we're the works of his hand. We're the workmanship of his hand. Hallelujah. We're seeing ourselves in the right light. We're seeing that we're the apple of his eye, and we're seeing that we're tattooed on the palm of his hands. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So we behold, I and the children whom the the Lord has given me are signs and wonders that are to take place in Israel from the Lord of hosts who dwells in Mount Zion. Hallelujah, glory to God. So not only are we blessed, but our children are going to be blessed, and they're going to be a sign and a wonder from God. Hallelujah. You need to decree and declare over your children that the fruit of my womb is blessed. You speak blessings over your children. That's your seed. That's a heritage from the Lord. That's a blessing from the Lord. We have to look at our children as blessings from the Lord. They are a gift of God to us. We have to speak life and healing over our children. Hallelujah, glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, glory to God. Thank you, Lord. And you reverence John 17:22 in your time of devotion. And it says that the God, the glory that you have given me, I have given them so that they may be one as we are one. Hallelujah. So God again is telling us here, hallelujah, that we're one with God. Remember that when Jesus was here in his earthly ministry, he prayed some prayers for us before he ascended back to the Father. Hallelujah. He said, Lord God, everything that you have given me, I give unto them. Hallelujah. You need to understand that God has given you everything pertaining to life and godliness. Hallelujah. He's equipped you with everything you need to make your life work. Hallelujah. So we're seeking the presence of God, the oneness of God. Hallelujah. When we dwell in his presence, we feel the experience of the fullness of joy. Hallelujah. And his pleasures evermore. Hallelujah. Christ had this attitude and disposition that said, it is not I, but the Christ within who does the work. This is the attitude and disposition that we have to have, that when you're doing your things in the world for your Lord, it is not I, but it's the Christ within me that's doing the work. Everything that you're endeavoring to do, you know that God is with you, he is for you, he is in you. Hallelujah. He said, be strong and of good courage because I'm with you. So when you know your God is with you, you walk in his confidence and you walk in his boldness because you know he has your back. Hallelujah. By honoring the presence of the Lord within yourself, hallelujah, you're honoring God as the strength and power that is enabling you to do things. When you're decreeing and declaring that I can do all things through Christ and strengthening me, you're saying that it's his strength and his power that's enabling me to do this. Hallelujah. I'm not trying to do it on my own strength. I'm not trying to do it in my own power. I'm moved by the Spirit of the living God. When I remember this truth, I am free from any self-driven thought, and I am able to give and receive the goodness of God. Hallelujah. You have to have a heart that's receptive to the goodness of God. You have to decree that I'm worthy of the best. Hallelujah. We cannot pray no longer that we're not worthy. If you really know that you're a new creation in God, you don't see yourself as wretched. You don't see yourself as the old Adam. The old Adam feels not good enough. He feels that he's not worthy. He feels that he's separate from God. He feels that he has to work to get God to do something. He feels like he got to put in all this work. He got to put in all this effort. He has to try to do everything according to the law. Hallelujah. But God brought Jesus on the scene. Hallelujah. To fulfill the law. And we can walk in grace. We can see the grace and we can see the mercy of God. And as we be quickened by his Spirit, we move as the second Adam. We're no longer walking in the old order. We're walking in a new reformation and a new order because we know who we are in God. Hallelujah. We're not fighting against flesh and blood and principalities and wickedness and all the darkness and things that are going on in the world. But you have to understand that you're seated with, in heavenly places with Christ Jesus, far above all the evil that's going on. So the devil is under your feet. You don't have to brag because the demons are subject to you. You brag because your name is in the Lamb Book of Life. But he is under our feet. So we say, Satan, the Lord rebuke you in the name of Jesus. We say, Lord, arise and let your enemies be scattered. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. In our prayer practice, your spiritual prayer practice, spend time connecting to the Christ within you. Christ in me, the hope of glory. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. In quiet times of your meditation and prayer, hallelujah, you get empowered, hallelujah, to be positive about yourself, to stop being so self-critical, to stop being so self-loathing, to stop beating yourself up, to stop looking at you through man's eyes, to stop seeing yourself as ugly or stupid or not valuable or whatever the negative things that you say about yourself. You know what I mean? How we put ourselves down when we make mistakes, when we miss the mark. He says, when you confess your sins, he's faithful. faithful and just to forgive you and cleanse you of all unrighteousness. Amen. Hallelujah. So God empowers you to see a positive image of yourself. Remember, you're looking in the mirror of God's word and you begin to see what God is seeing. It was a song that said, Lord, help me to see what you see. Hallelujah. You see me rejoicing. You see me faithful. Hallelujah. You see me victorious. You got to see yourself as a victorious person. Hallelujah. You're moving from the victim consciousness. Hallelujah. You're moving from the powerlessness state of consciousness. Hallelujah. Because when you receive Christ, you receive power. Hallelujah. You have power, hallelujah, to change some things about yourself and the way you perceive some things. You have the power to pull down those strongholds and those vain thoughts and imagination that exalted itself against the knowledge of God's will. Hallelujah. Your upbeat attitude will shape your life and affect change for good. Hallelujah. God is looking at your attitude and your disposition, even in your trials and tribulations. Hallelujah. By allowing free expression from the inside out, you begin to rest in the truth that the kingdom of God is not in observance, but is inside of you. Hallelujah, glory to God. A lot of pain that we feel is comparing ourselves to other people. A lot of pain is when we look into other people and we're judging ourselves, hallelujah, based on what they're going through and what their lives look like. Amen. But God, he has given you something on the inside of you. Remember, he's equipped you and given you everything pertaining to life and godliness. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, when you begin to live and rest in that truth again, that the kingdom of God is not an observance but inside of you, you begin to experience life in a sense of wonder and awe. You begin to embrace God and be just basking his presence and his love and his goodness and mercy. Hallelujah. I invite you to joy, to then you begin to invite joy to live in your heart, and it will flow from you to other people. Christ in me, the hope of glory, is working in me and through me, and my life is filled with innumerable blessings. So you got to rest in these type of truths, the spiritual truths. Now God, he says, he's also substance. He's substance. And that means that when we receive the Father, when we're looking at his Abba Father, we receive divine energy. Hallelujah. He's a divine energy manifesting in all areas of our life. As we're moving in this oneness consciousness with God, you begin to decree, I am one with this energy field, and I'm in alignment with the Christ consciousness because I have this mind in me, which is in Christ Jesus. I release then sense consciousness and sin consciousness, and I rest in being the righteousness of God through Christ. So when you're moving in sense consciousness, you're looking at everything how it looks according to your senses, and you're not able to walk in faith, because faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Amen. Hallelujah. So when you begin to live from the righteousness consciousness, you begin to decree and declare that in him I live and move and have my very being. Hallelujah. When you begin to operate this way, it's going to lift up your vibration. Hallelujah. When you operate on this higher vibration and this higher frequency, you can open up to the good and new possibilities in your life. Did you hear what I said? When you lift up your vibration, hallelujah, you operate in this higher vibration, you will begin to be open to the good and the new possibilities in your life. Hallelujah. Life is your breath. When you know that in him you live and move and have your being, you pattern your whole life according to this truth, this spiritual truth. When wholeness lives in you, the one that resurrected from the dead is living in you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. You have an intelligent God, and you begin to honor the intelligence that you are because you're made in his image and likeness. When God said you're very good, you need to agree with him. I'm very good. God said I am. You understand? Hallelujah. God, give God a yes, a real yes. Hallelujah. On today, make better choices and take a leap of faith. Hallelujah. Every day we got choices to choose life and death. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. So we and some of us are in a transition. Hallelujah. We've experienced some things, some setbacks, some things that have shaken us to our core. Hallelujah. Some unexpected events, some unplanned events. But they are working to grow you up and to mature you. Because God wants a spiritual control a mature offspring. Amen. Glory to God. In your time of devotion, look at Proverbs 16 and meditate on that. And it helps you be able to release your will to God's will. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. So God in this hour, hallelujah, is raising our field of consciousness. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You have to have a spirit of joy and anticipation. And when you have this, God is going to remove your fear as you rest in his love for you, because his love casted out all fear. Hallelujah. God in this season is enabling us to lead out of our being and to be of maximum service to God and mankind. Hallelujah. As you begin to trust God to supply all your needs, hallelujah, according to his riches and glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So as we're having this posture and this disposition, hallelujah, putting our focus on what's primary to God's heart. Hallelujah. Lord God, I want to know what's on your heart, and I want to know what's on your mind. Hallelujah. God says you begin to walk circumspectly. You begin to walk with sober judgment. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. You let your yes be yes, and your no be no, and you be clear about it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So you're not going to be double-minded. You're going to be single-minded. Hallelujah. Make a choice this week and take some action. Hallelujah. Be honest with yourself. Hallelujah. Do honest observation. Observe your thoughts. Hallelujah. Examine your thoughts through the word to see if it's in alignment with what God is saying. Hallelujah. Begin to be aware of the vibration energy that you're operating in. And then when you see that this particular thought process or these energies that I'm carrying is not giving me any joy, any peace, hallelujah, you begin to shift. You got to do a paradigm shift. You got to shift the way you're thinking. You got to begin to pull down that thought. This thought is not of God. In the name of Jesus, I am who God says I am. I can do what God says I can do. I am the righteousness of God. I am a new creation. Old things are past, I become new. My sin and my iniquity, God remembers no more. He threw them in the sea of forgetfulness. Hallelujah. When the enemy want to remind you of where you came from, you got to let that devil know, hallelujah, that I am be before me with integrity, knowing that you are always in my presence, and be blameless and complete and in obedience to me. Hallelujah, glory to God. This means that in this season you're about to meet El Shaddai. Hallelujah, El Shaddai in his fullness. Hallelujah, he will give you a new name. Hallelujah, he's a God, almighty God. Chief cornerstone. This is from the Lord's doing, and it's marvelous in our eyes. This is the day which the Lord has brought about. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Save now, beseech you, Lord. Send now prosperity. Oh, Lord, I beseech you to give us success. You need to decree that over your life. Oh, Lord, send now prosperity and give us good success. Hallelujah. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. We bless you from the house of the Lord. You come into the sanctuary under his guardianship. So when you receive him as Abba Father, you come into his sanctuary under his guardianship. When you're under his guardianship, you see him as that protector, as that nourisher, as that guider. You see him, you trust in him that he's ordering your steps. The Lord is God who has shown and given us light. He has illuminated us with his grace and freedom and joy. Hallelujah, glory to God. Hallelujah. As we experience El Shaddai, begin to decree and declare that I am God all powerful. Hallelujah. He's all powerful. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. As we get this together, as we're putting our primary focus on God's heart, walking in intimacy to know him, hallelujah, we begin to decree what he says. You are God Almighty. I will walk before you and be blameless. I will live a blameless life. God, you're all powerful. I will obey you, hallelujah, without blame. I will live in a way, Lord God, that pleases you, because you are sovereign God, ruler of heaven and earth, calling forth loyal and obedient service. How you begin to decree and declare that you are El Shaddai. I live in your presence with integrity. I live in constant awareness that you are always with me. Hallelujah, glory to God. Hallelujah. Abram's name change is confirmed to him in the promise. Hallelujah. Receive your name change on today. Know that God is all sufficient. Walk before him and be upright. Walk in his presence. Be pure in heart. Hallelujah. Walk with him. Be trustworthy. Walk and live habitually before your God. Perfect and blameless. Wholehearted and complete. Know that you're complete in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. I decree and declare. Hallelujah. As you begin to release limitations, release resentments, release fear. Hallelujah. And live in freedom and love in the name of Jesus. Release doubt and error thinking from your life today in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Understand that you have the mind of Christ, and he is expressing as you. Hallelujah. As you say that I am one with God. I am a co-creator with God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We trust his infinite creative wisdom. Hallelujah. He's the source of all ideas. We reverence and honor his omnipotence, his omnipresence, his omnipresence, his omniscience. Hallelujah. All powerful, all knowing, all seeing, ever present. Hallelujah. Always with you. Hallelujah. This is God. This is the issue of God's government. Hallelujah. Jesus. Hallelujah. As we begin to walk as the righteousness of God. Hallelujah. We begin to walk in a theocracy, God rule. Hallelujah. And we begin to build accountability structures. Hallelujah. We begin to trust the power to enforce our spiritual authority as we enforce God's order and standards of righteousness in God's government. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. As wise elders building unity till we all come into the unity of the faith. Hallelujah. God has called us as administrators to equip you ministers. Hallelujah. For the work of the ministry. Hallelujah. Because you have need of training. Hallelujah. God is blessing the fivefold ministry to function. Hallelujah. In this apostolic government to foster kingdom growth. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We're an extension of God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. As we begin to travail in prayer, hallelujah. What does it mean to be travailing in the spirit? Remember Paul, the apostle. He said he did travail on behalf of others in the spirit until the spirit of Christ was formed within them. Hallelujah. As we as intercessors, that's what our job is to do. We are to be in travail in the spirit to Christ is formed within us and in others. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So again, hallelujah. Let me repeat that again. Paul the apostle did travail on behalf of others in the spirit until the spirit of Christ was formed in those in whom God had placed in his heart. Hallelujah. When you're travailing in the spirit, it means to travail or labor as in giving birth. Just as a woman in her natural travails when she's about to deliver her child. When you have spiritual travail, hallelujah, there's a level of intensity marked by the Holy Spirit. And God gives you a burden to bring it to pass through prayer and giving him the promises. He gives you prophetic insight and the Holy Spirit begins to illuminate the word. Hallelujah, glory to God. So you need to understand the pain that you feel is birthing pains when you're giving birth to greatness. Hallelujah, glory to God. Hallelujah. So, hallelujah. God has, hallelujah, given me the authority, hallelujah, and as his apostle, I'm called by God, hallelujah. He says, I did not appoint myself. It is a call from above. As an apostle of God himself assessed me, hallelujah, called me and sent me out to serve his purpose, hallelujah, in the places that he appointed, hallelujah. So when you know that you're an apostle walking in God, hallelujah, you know that you, he sends you to certain atmospheres. He sends you to certain localities for his purpose and the places where he is appointed. Hallelujah. Remember when God called Moses in the wilderness out of the burning bush. He answered him and he called him for a specific task and a specific purpose for a specific people. Hallelujah. He gave Moses a sign. Hallelujah. For his assignment. And he assured him that he would be with him. Hallelujah. And then he gave a sign to those who were assigned to him that God was with him. Hallelujah. So that they would accept him. Hallelujah. And make it possible for him to complete his assignment. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So as you know that God has sent us, hallelujah, to help you with your assignments. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And as an apostle, again, as a sent out one, hallelujah, with an outward thrust and to pioneer or restore some things. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And to make impact. Hallelujah. To cause a new movement to happen. Hallelujah. In the region that you're assigned to. Hallelujah. Remember as an apostle. Hallelujah. As a commander with a mandate. Hallelujah. With extended vision. Hallelujah. Which is cross-cultural and global. Hallelujah. She or he is called and raised and equipped for the job for the hour. Hallelujah. The apostolic government is a theocratic government where the word of God reigns. Hallelujah. It reigns supreme. Where the leadership is strong and the fellowship is intelligent. Where the revelations are from above. Hallelujah. That is going to chart your course. It's going to give you direction. It's going to hold you accountable to God first. Hallelujah. Although the apostle was accountable to the people under him or her, it's not in the same way as he reports to his God. Jesus is our Lord and Savior. Hallelujah. And our accountability is him as his disciple. Hallelujah. We receive instruction from the Father in heaven. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So we bless God for this word on today as we're going to walk, hallelujah, in the apostolic order. Hallelujah. Through prayer. An apostle who will be able
Hallelujah, glory to God. Remember that Jesus is our chief apostle, and then we walk in consistency with God, have a consistent prayer life that is constantly puts us in touch with the counsel of heaven, hallelujah, and agent of heaven in the earth. So we're agents, hallelujah, in the earth, hallelujah. So we bless God for this mighty word. For the Holy Spirit is empowering us to pray, giving us what to do, what to pray about, hallelujah, and what to do in this next hour. The Holy Spirit, that power, hallelujah. When we submit to God, we resist the devil when he begins to flee, hallelujah. So in our prayer, we communicate with God and proclaim, hallelujah, and decree and declare his orders, his instructions, his directives, hallelujah. We led by his spirit, hallelujah. And we make it known to every principality and power and force and dominion and government that Christ is Lord, hallelujah, that we're walking in divine order and divine manifestation as we're experiencing El Shaddai in this season, God Almighty, hallelujah. So we bless God for this word, hallelujah. Were you blessed on today, hallelujah?